हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू। मायसेल्फ देवेश सिंह। वंस अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोसीड दिस चैप्टर, व्हाट इज डेमोक्रेसी एंड व्हाई डेमोक्रेसी। दिस टाइम स्टूडेंट्स वी हैव टू प्रोसीड दिस न्यू टॉपिक, आर्गुमेंट्स अगेंस्ट डेमोक्रेसी। एज इन द लास्ट वीडियो आई हैड एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट democracy and related to this topic I had told you many incidents related to Mexico, Zimbabwe, China and other many countries where is no democracy. Here the conversation has most of the arguments that we routinely hear against democracy. Today we have some points and discussing over these points we have to check out the values that is against democracy. Leaders keep changing in a democracy. This leads to instability. This is the points that suggest us that there is no stability in our country in the political fields. Any times our political leaders turns their condition from one to another party and without majority in the election result, there is no stability for the government. So turning of the leaders from one to another party makes instability in the country's government. Democracy is all about political competition and power play. There is no scope for morality. We can say that wherever is democracy, everywhere you can see the big political competition, and this political competition play the role. There is also no scope for morality. So many people have to be consulted in a democracy that it leads to delay. Many people also share their ideas, their views related to democracy, that in democratic country government is not so active to lead any decision very rapidly. So many bills stays for a long time and it leads to delays. Elected leaders do not know the best interest of the people. It leads to bad decision. The elected leaders also are unknown about the best interest of the people. They can't read the mind of the people. They can't read the opinion of the people, that what is their great desire, what they want, what is their opinion. And in that condition, those leaders in that condition, they took some bad decision. Democracy leads to corruption, for it is based on electoral competition. In a democratic country, you can see there are many corruption, as the result, the rule is based on electoral competition. You can check out many decisions related to our country. Before the NDA government in India, there was the government of Congress, and at that time, just after the electoral competition, Congress was in the government, and there were the big scam like that, coal scam, Commonwealth game scam, uh, 2G, 3G spectrum scam happened, and a very heavy amount of Indian economy was disturbed. So ordinary people don't know what is good for them. They should not decide anything. In democracy, the ordinary people are also unknown about their good or bad. They should not decide anything, and they are unable to read the mind of the government, as they have no idea about the government and government's new policies. Are there some other arguments against democracy that you can think of? Which of these arguments applies mainly to democracy? Which of these can apply to misuse of any form of government? Which of those do you agree with? Here it is said that it is said that if you have any arguments related to the democracy, you can also mention it. You can also share your ideas and that will be appreciable for this topic, argument against democracy. Clearly, democracy is not a magical solution for all the problem, and it is also accepted that democracy is the best form of government, but sometimes it makes the clarity that democracy has not all the magical solution for all the problem. It has not ended poverty in our country, and in the other parts of the world. Democratic government is not free to take any decision, as it is bounded with many pressures of political parties and also of the citizens. Democracy as a form of government only ensures that people take their own decision, and the democratic governments can only ensure the people, the citizens, to take their own decision, and this doesn't guarantee that their decision will be good. Their decision will be good. People can make mistake. This is the natural habit of the people, that they could make mistake. Involving the people in this decision does lead to delay in decision making. It is also true that democracy leads to frequent changes in leadership. And this is also a big truth in the democratic country, that democracy leads to frequent changes in leadership. Sometimes this can set back big decisions, and affect the government's efficiency. These arguments show that democracy of the kind we see may not be the ideal form of government, but that is not a question we face in real life. The real question we face is different. Is democracy better than other form of government that are there for us to choose from? In some matter, we can say that democracy is a good form of government, but we can never say that this is the ideal form of government, because in some real life's question, there is many variation, and in the matter of taking decisions, sometimes the democratic government leaves behind than the non-democratic country. So it can never says that only democratic country's democratic government is good and good form of the government in each way. Sometimes non-democratic rules shows some good values, that is for the welfare of the country. Like that, we will take the example of China, where there is a single party and they have extended the timing of the president Xi Jinping for a long term, and he is also doing good for the country without any pressure from decision are taken by the government in China. So this shows that in some condition China's government is better than a democratic government.